Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy, and today we're talking about coordinate systems, the solution to an equation. And when you have a solution to an equation that has an x and a y like this, then you have to have two parts to your solution, an x and a y part. And since we've just been talking about the coordinate system, you may come to you that we need to have an ordered pair when we talk about the solution. So what we want to know is, what is a combination for x and y that would make this statement true? Some x plus some y equals 5. Think of anything. And the ones that people sort of usually yell out right away are like 2 and 3. That's true. That would be a solution. What's another solution? Because the thing about these is that there's an infinite number. But what's another obvious one? Maybe 1 and 4. What's something else? Well, if x was 0, y could be 5. What's another one? Well, we could flip-flop these. X could be 3 and y could be 2. We could flip-flop that one. X could be 4 and y could be 1. But wait a minute. Couldn't I say, what if x is 1 half? If x is 1 half, y could be 4 and a half. I don't have to just stick with whole numbers. In fact, I could use negatives. I could say, well, what if x was negative 3. Well, if x was negative 3, y could be 8. And what we start to see is, whoa, we could sit here for the rest of our lives and give solutions to that equation. All those solutions are going to be given as ordered pairs. So what about this one, another one? X minus y is 1. What's a solution to that? You could think of anything. And this is one of the things about graphing that students have issue with, is like, I don't want to come up with my own. I want somebody to tell me what to do. You have to be coming up with your own as you graph. First, we're going to give you help. Here's half of it. Find the other half. But what you have to get used to is that we can see there's an infinite number of solutions. You can pick whatever you want. If you're going to have to graph it on a coordinate system, you don't want to choose 20 minus 19 because you don't want to draw that big. So all we're saying is, like, if x was 5, then y could be 4, and that would make that true, right? If x was 1, y could be 0. 1 minus 0 is 1. Anything I choose, I could choose x to be negative 2, and then y would have to be negative 3. Now, maybe you can't do that in your head, but you can plug them in and see that it's true. My point here is that there's an infinite number of solutions. I could say x is 2.3, and then y could be 1.3. If I subtracted those, I'd get 1, right? So I could have decimal solutions. I can have fraction solutions. I can have negative. I can have zeros. There's an infinite number of solutions to this. And that was the problem that Rene Descartes faced when he was looking at this. And the reason he came up with the coordinate system, which we'll look at more in detail, is that we can't list all the solutions, so maybe we could just show a picture of it. And a picture of those solutions is where you get your linear equation, your graph, your linear graph. Okay, one more. What if they were rearranged differently and we were looking for a solution? Can you think of a solution that would make this true as an ordered pair? Well, if x was 0, y would be negative 2, because 0 minus 2. If x was 1, 1 minus 2, y would be negative 1, right? All we have to do is pick an x and plug it in, and we could see it. What if we said x was 5, 5 minus 2, y would be 3. Or if x was 4, 4 minus 2, y would be 2. We can pick solutions for equations all day long. If that's all we want to do is just think of a solution for this equation, that's all we'd have to do. So now, I want you to think about this. For this equation, 2x plus y equals 3, is this a solution? Okay? So what I'm asking you to do is to say, if you make x 2 and y negative 1, will you get 3? Because if you do, then this is a solution. And if you don't, then it's not a solution. So one of the things you're going to be asked to do is given an equation, decide which point which points are solutions. And when you have this kind of a problem, it might be that one of them is a solution or maybe all four. You don't know. You have to try them all. How would you do that? Well, we've already done substitution before. X is 2, so I'm going to replace the 2x with 2 times 2. Y is negative 1, and I have warned you before to plug in your values, put parentheses around them. It just helps make sense of things. So 2 times 2 is 4, plus negative 1 is 3. 4 and negative 1 is 3. So yes, I'm going to circle this because it is a solution. All right? You should try the others on your own and then come back and see how you did. What about the second one? If x is 0 and y is 3, well, 0 plus 3 is another solution, right? Because 3 equals 3. This one also is a solution. Maybe they all are. Check them all. Okay, the next one, 2 times negative 1 plus y, y we know is 0, plus 0 equals 3. 2 times negative 1 is negative 2 plus 0 equals 3. Negative 2 does not equal 3. This one is not a solution. That's how you decide if something is a solution or not. Plug it in. If it makes it true, it's a solution. If it makes it false, it's not a solution. All right, the last one, 2 times negative 2, that's what x is, plus y, which is 7, is supposed to be 3. 2 times negative 2 is negative 4, plus 7 equals 3. Negative 4 and 7 is 3. 3 equals 3. This is another solution. So when you're asked, is something a solution to an equation, you plug it in to determine that. So there's one more that I want you to try, and I would like you to try it by shutting off the video and then trying it and coming back and checking your work, but we're going to work it out here for those of you non-pausers. All right, so I know here that this has to be the x and this has to be the y. Even though y is listed first, I need to be careful that I put y in for y. So that's 4. And x is 0 plus 4. Well, 0 is just gone, so 4 equals 4. This is a solution. I'll put some negatives in there and negatives because that's hard for students, so be careful. Y is 5. That was over here on the left side. And then I have negative, and then I have negative 1. Notice in the last example, I put parentheses around 0. I didn't really need to there. But it's nice to have done it here, and if you always put parentheses, you'll be on the right side of that argument. All right, so then add 4. So then I have 5 equals negative times negative is positive 1 plus 4, or 5 equals 5, and that's true. This is a solution. What about this one, negative 2, 2? Well, y needs to be 2. I have a negative out front, and I'm plugging in a negative 2. So I have negative negative 2, which is positive 2, plus 4, and 2 equals 6. Not true. This is not a solution. What about negative 4, 0? Well, y is 0. X is negative 4, and I had a negative out front, and I have a negative 4, and then negative negative 4 is 4, plus 4, 0 equals 8. No, it does not equal 8. So that's not a solution either. So when you're checking your equations for solutions, plug in and see if it makes both of them, if it makes this equation true. Have a great day.